The Zeitgeist movement is not a political movement. It does not recognize divisionary notions such as nations, governments, races, religions, creeds, or class. Rather, we see the world as one organism, with the human species as a singular family. Simultaneously, we acknowledge that we depend entirely on our environment, not only in regard to the necessities of life, such as food, air, and water, but also for influence and guidance in regard to life's processes. We recognize and understand that aligning ourselves with natural processes is the most progressive and productive disposition we can have. The Zeitgeist movement, in fact, is the activist arm of the Venus Project, an organization which constitutes the lifelong work of industrial designer and social engineer Jacques Fresco. Simply put, what the Venus Project represents and what the Zeitgeist movement hence condones could be summarized as the application of the scientific method for social concern. One of the greatest discoveries of humankind, which has allowed for tremendous advancement in our abilities on this planet, has been the understanding and application of science. Through the humane application of science and technology to social design and decision-making, we have the means to transform our environment into something exceedingly more balanced, organized, humane, productive, and most importantly, sustainable. As many are aware at this time, both our societal integrity and ecological integrity are in serious question. The current economic system is falling apart at an accelerating rate, with the prospect of worldwide unemployment and destabilization occurring possibly on the largest scale ever seen. Simultaneously, we are courting the point of no return in regard to the destruction of the environment. Given the current state of affairs, many of which will be addressed in the first part of this presentation, the viewer should find that we not only need to move in another direction, we have to.
The old appeals to racial, sexual, and religious chauvinism, to rabid nationalist fervor, are beginning not to work.
This is who I am, and whether I'm good or bad or achieving or not, all that's learned along the way.
Because it's just a ride, and we can change it anytime we want.
It's only a choice. No effort, no work, no job, no savings of money.
I realized that I had the game wrong. The game was to find out what I already was.
Now, evolution did not end with us growing thumbs. And the reason our institutions, our traditional religions are all crumbling is because they're no longer relevant.
Kids will ask their parents, "Dad, couldn't you see that war was inevitable when you produce scarcity?"
Power does what it wants. Power does what it wants. And now they're just more naked about it. Now they just put it right out front and say, "This is what we're doing to you folks." And everybody's got a cell phone that makes pancakes, so they don't want to rock the boat.
The entire money structured and materialistic oriented society is a false society.
There is no human nature. There's human behavior. And that's always been changed throughout history.
What we need is a true change of consciousness, where we understand the interrelationship between all of us.
There are no Negro problems, or Polish problems, or Jewish problems, or Greek problems, or women's problems. They're human problems.
The society that we're about to talk about is a society that is free of all the old superstitions, incarceration, prisons, police, bankers, advertising, gone forever, because it's no longer relevant.